हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अप टू टॉपिक्स. फर्स्ट इज न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स एंड अंडर न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ एनिमल्स वी विल ऑल्सो स्टडी होलोजोइक न्यूट्रिशन विच इज प्रैक्टिस्ड इन एनिमल्स ओनली. लेट मी हेल्प यू टू रिकॉल वॉट वी हैव स्टडीड इन आवर लास्ट क्लास. वी हैव स्टडीड द फूड चेन एंड द फूड चेन स्टेट्स दैट प्लांट्स आर द प्रोड्यूसर्स. दे मेक देयर ओन फूड विद द हेल्प ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस. In the presence of sunlight, they take water and carbon dioxide and they make up their own food with the help of photosynthesis, so they are producers. And those animals which eat plants are herbivores and they are primary consumers. There are some animals which may eat primary consumers and which may eat producers also. They are secondary consumers, they are omnivore. Then there are some animals which may eat secondary consumer and primary consumer, therefore they are tertiary consumers, they are carnivores. And along with this, there are decomposers. Decomposers are those organisms which feed on dead and decaying plants and animals. So they feed on the complex, they break up the complex organic matter into simple form and return it back to the environment. This we have studied earlier. Now let us see what is holozoic nutrition. All the animals follow a mode of nutrition which is called holozoic nutrition. Holozoic nutrition means ingesting complex organic matter and converting it into simpler form with the help of digestion. So we all eat up whatever we take, whatever we intake. It's a complex organic matter because we are not able to make our own food with the help of any process named as photosynthesis or anything like that. So we take up a food in a complex form and then we have to perform digestion to break up this complex organic matter into simple form. So such mode is called holozoic nutrition. So all herbivores, carnivores and omnivores follow this mode of holozoic nutrition. Now under holozoic nutrition there can be some association. Association means there can be some group, some relations between the animals, and let us study these relations. First is saprozoic relation. In this relation, in this association, some organisms feed on the dead and decaying matter. They feed on this dead and decaying matter. So they are known as scavengers. Okay, the example is vulture, crow, hyena, etc. Then another example is parasitic. This is parasitic relation. In this relation, this is a relation between two organisms. One is host and one is parasite. In this, one animal, the animal which derive their nutrition from other organism is known as parasite, and it causes harm to the host. What is host? The organism on which they feed are known as host. So they take their nutrition from the host and they cause harm to the host. For example, leech is a parasite. It sucks blood from the cattle, so it causes harm to the cattle. Head lice is another example, and it is a parasite that feed on dogs and humans. Then one more relation is mutualistic relation, association. Some animals live in association, in such association that both the organisms are benefited, both of them get benefit. For example, this is a bird, oxpecker. It stays on rhino and it eats up all the bugs and parasites on the body from the body of rhino. So this bird is getting food and rhino is getting cleaning of its body, and also this bird warns this rhino about the approaching predators. So both of these organisms are getting benefit. Such relation is mutualistic. Okay, we have studied about the associations. Now let us study holozoic nutrition in bit detail. We have already seen that holozoic nutrition is a process of obtaining nutrition by intake of complex organic matter, and then it is digested into simpler forms and then is absorbed. So what are the steps? First is ingestion, that is taking up food through mouth. Then is digestion, that is breaking down of complex food into simple one. And then is absorption, that is absorbing these simple food, simple form into the bloodstream. Then is assimilation. It is synthesis of the new substance with the help of these absorbed material. And then is ejection. That is the removal of undigested or unwanted food out of the body, which is also known as excretion. Now, in amoeba, for example, amoeba is a unicellular organism. It contains, its body have only one cell, and it is also a prokaryotic cell. So, in amoeba, how does holozoic nutrition process? How does holozoic nutrition is done in amoeba? Okay, first of all, amoeba stays in stagnant water pools and ditches, etc. Finger-like projections called pseudopodia helps to capture the food. It extends its pseudopodia and engulfs the food. And this phenomenon is known as phagocytosis. Now, phenocytosis is also there. Phenocytosis is cell drinking. Whenever amoeba feels that water is there, water absorption is required by this amoeba cell, then cell drinking, that is phenocytosis, is done by the amoeba, okay, with the help of pseudopodia. Let us see in detail what happens. Amoeba eats tiny microscopic plants and animals such as food, which floats in water. Now, when amoeba encounters a suitable organism, it pushes out its pseudopodia around the organism and encircles the food. You can see in the diagram that the finger-like projection pseudopodia is extended to capture this food particle. And then gradually the tips of pseudopodia fuse with each other and the food is engulfed with the little surrounding water and forms a bag-like structure called as food vacuole inside it. Then within the body of the amoeba, within the cell, the enzymes are present that breaks the food into simple soluble substance. Then that food is absorbed with the help of absorbed directly into the cytoplasm only, because it has already been digested. Then assimilation. The digested food absorbed by the cytoplasm is stored or utilized for the growth, development, multiplication and release of energy. So you can see that pseudopodia is capturing this food, then it got enclosed in a form of food vacuole, food and water. Then it, with the help of enzymes, it got digested within the cytoplasm, and food is digested and soluble material and absorbed, assimilated, used up. And then unwanted, this last point, ejection. This undigested food collects inside the vacuole and the cell membrane suddenly ruptures at any place, and the undigested food is thrown outside the body of the vacuole. This is how holozoic nutrition occurs in amoeba.